Let us see the past year paper. The number of vehicles moving in a specified direction on a given lane and passing a given point during a specified unit of time is called traffic density, traffic volume, traffic capacity, and basic capacity. So, the correct answer is option B, traffic volume. Let us see one question of the past GATE paper. Which of the following vehicular traffic intersections converts all crossing into merging and diverging sequences? Option A, rotary. Option B, manual signaling. Option 3, grade separation. Option D, automatic signaling. The correct answer is rotary. Let us see some questions which has been asked in the GATE architecture. Question number 1. Desire line diagram helps in option A, completion of a project by a desired date. Option B, meeting demand and supply in desired category of housing. Option C, determining income versus expenditure pattern of individuals. Option D, origin and destination analysis in transport planning. Here, the correct option will be option D, that is the origin and destination analysis in transport planning. The second question was of similar type, that is, desired lines are associated with option A, origin and destination analysis in transport planning. Option B, income expenditure analysis in personal finance management. Option C, cut fill analysis in landscape planning. Option D, demand and supply analysis in economic planning. So the correct answer is origin and destination analysis in transport planning. As you can see, the desired line diagram question, it has appeared 2 times in the GATE architecture paper. Let us see now past year GATE question papers. The first question is, particles of soil in descending order of grain size is, 4 options are given. Gravel, sand, silt, clay. Option 2, gravel, sand, clay, silt. Option 3, sand, gravel, clay, silt. And option D, clay, gravel, sand, silt. As we have already discussed, the particles of soil in descending order of grain size is gravel, sand, silt, clay. The next question is, damage of foundation due to soil liquefaction is related to A, cyclone, B, landslide, C, floods, D, earthquake. So the option, correct option is soil liquefaction. This term is related to earthquake. Next question is, match the terms in group 1 with the definitions in group 2. Column 1 has been given some terminologies: permeability, shear strength, bearing capacity, and pH level. So let us see, as we have already learned, the permeability is, it will be the option 2, the ease with which water can flow through soil. Number 2, shear strength. Shear strength is what? It determines the stability of the soil and its ability to resist failure under loading. Number 3, bearing capacity. Bearing capacity means the load which a soil is able to support. And pH level, this is pH level shows the ability of the soil to support plant growth. So these are the past year question papers I have discussed here.